In this video, I'm going to show you how to use user forms, shortcuts, and menus for navigation. I'm going to also show you a few tricks and also how to get certain codes to be able to use. So this example, I've just used one of Microsoft's standard programs. So what's nice about this one is it's got three sheets. So it's got the key metric settings, financial data input, and our financial report. So this is a report. We've got three sheets. So obviously any type of report can have multiple sheets and it can be a lot. So in most cases you won't need navigation for three sheets, but I'm going to show you the example on this three sheets because it might be hundreds of sheets that you're using and you might want to let somebody work with the actual sheet you want them to work with. So the first step before we start, we need to save this worksheet as a macro-enabled sheet. So I'm going to Excel macro-enabled workbook, because if we don't do that, our user forms and buttons and shortcuts won't work after we've closed the sheet. So now we've got a macro-enabled sheet. The first step is we need to create a sheet called menu. The reason why I do this, because you can let the whole thing run on user forms, but user forms always pops up anywhere it wants. So for me, working with a menu is just much cleaner and works better. So the first step, we've got three sheets. We need to create three different buttons. So I'm just going to say record. I'm going to say OK. And I'm just going to stop it because this is just navigation. It's going to be a manual thing. So this one, the first one I'm going to say, so user form, so that's a simple one, and then I also want to do three more. So the first one, when I say record and say okay, so it's busy recording. You can see that by it saying stop recording at the bottom. So this button, when I click on it, I want it to go to financial reports and click on B2. So let's just stop that. So that will be, so now we've recorded the basic macro there, and this one we'll go to my financial report. Then the next button, we're going to say record. We're going to say okay. So again, we can see it's busy recording. This one, we want to go to financial data input and click on B6. So let's just stop that. And then we can rename that. We can call that financial data input. And then the last button we're going to need, gonna say record, okay, busy recording. It's gonna go to our key metric settings and click on B2. Let's just stop that, and then we can rename that one as well. So key metric settings. Okay, the next step, we need to get them all the same size. So let's go to format control. The first size is 0.37, 1.23. So let's just get all the ones on that, 0.37, 1.23. Okay, so that's the same size. We can just use the arrows to move it, just to get it nicely tucked in there. Let's go to format control, 0.37, 1.23. Again, we can use the arrow just to move it around. It's a bit easier than moving with the mouse. Tuck it just under that, so it's just a bit out still. And then the last one, also 0.37, 1.23. So yeah, we can move that as well. There we go. So now, because we've got all the same size, we can select them all and make them all a bit bigger. So there we've got our three buttons. So now you can make it a bit easier. Let's just hide all this columns so it looks a bit better. And then I'm going to hide all the rows as well. I'm just shift end and down. And now it's all hidden. Then we can move them. It's always, you always need to make them look nice. And then there we can just create a heading, merge and center, and we just say this is our financial report. And this we can just make bold and make it a color just to make it look nice. Okay, so now we've created our first sheet called menu. The next thing we want to do is when we open up this workbook, it needs to go here automatically, because it might be that we save the sheet and it's currently on the financial report, but when we save it and close, it's going to always want to go there. So how do you do that? Let's go to our developer toolbar. Going to go to this workbook, and then we're going to write the private sub. Private, and how does that look? So it's a private sub workbook open. So every time we open up this workbook, it should go to sheets, menu, select. So every time we open up this workbook, it's going to go to this menu and select it. So it doesn't matter where we've saved it, it will always go there. So next step. So now we've built our first navigation, we can even take out the grid lines. So now it looks quite nice. The next step now would be to test this buttons of us. So the user form obviously won't work because we haven't done one yet. The financial report, so that goes to the financial report. Financial data input goes there. And the metric settings, so that's perfect. So now let's do the user form. So if you go to view code, I'm just going to say insert user form. So now that this is our user form. So this is going to be a simplistic user form. We're going to use this for navigation. I'm just going to insert three buttons. I'm actually going to do four buttons because we need one that closes the user form. So the first button is going to go to financial reports. The second button is going to go to financial data input. And the last button, so we're doing this all at the caption, it's going to go to key metric settings. And then this final button is just going to say close. So to get a code on a specific button, you need to double click on it. So this code goes to sheet. Just make sure you get the spelling right, financial report. Select. And just before we do that, we need to say user form 1 hide, because otherwise this user form is just going to stay open. So I'm just going to copy this code, I'm going to double click on user form, go to the next one, paste that, double click on it, go to the last one, paste that, double click again, go to close and paste it. So now we can just end this. So let's just hide this first one. Let's edit that one. That one will go to financial data input, and this one will go to key metric settings. Okay, so let's go see if this works. So if I click on show user form, it doesn't work because I haven't done the code yet. So we right click on it, go to view code. So this specific user form will say user form 1 show, and that will then physically show the user form for us. So let's go test that. So if I click on this now, our user form shows. So now the first one will go to financial reports. So there we are. So can you see now, every time we want to open this user form, we have to go to menu. So I want to actually create a shortcut where I can just say show user form. So let's do that. So I'm just going to say record macro. I'm going to make this control Q. Let's put a description there that says show user form. So okay, so now we're busy recording. I can't show a user form with a macro, so I need to stop it then. Then let's go to our code, module 1. So there you'll see this is the last one. You can see it sort of shows us the shortcut. So this shortcut will say user form 1 show. Okay, let's go test that. So if we go show user form, we go to this one, so that one works. So now I'm going to click Control Q, and there's our user form. Go to financial reports, financial data, key metric settings, and close. So now we've done a menu where we can go to the physical sheets. We've got shortcuts where we can go back to the user form. Let's create another shortcut. This one is going to say Control M, and this one will go back to menu. So let's say OK. I'm just going to stop it, go to our modules. This will be at the end. This one will say Sheets, Menu, Select. So now we've got menus that goes all the way. So if I click Control M, it goes back to my menu. So now we've got menus and navigational buttons that goes everywhere, and we've got all the capabilities that you need. So you could have, instead of going to the menu when we open this up, we could go to this and say Show User Form. So anything you want to do there, you can do in when you open up this workbook. For me, it works better to go to a physical menu because it makes your program look more professional when you've got one menu. The other thing which you also can do is you can hide or unhide this sheet. So there's an option in Excel where you can actually do that. So we're just going to do a shortcut for it, so then it makes it a bit easier. So I'm going to say Record Macro. I'm going to say Control V. So what this shortcut will do is hide all sheets. So let's say OK. So it's busy recording. So I'm going to go to File, Options. If you go to Advanced, so it's somewhere in the middle, you'll see something called Show Sheet Tabs. I'm just going to just unclick that. So now it's gone. So that's Control W. So let's stop this. Let's record another one. I'm going to say here Control E and say Show All Sheets. So this one, I'm going to go to File, Options, Advanced, then go back to Sheet, and now I'm going to show it. So now it's either Control V where I hide it or Control E where I show it. So now if you do this, then when we open up this workbook, it's going to go to Menu. Then we've got one place where we can navigate from. And then when we're in our physical sheets, you can go back to Menu, or you can just show the user form. So can you see now we've got a perfect navigational route which we can follow. So people must follow your program because they can't even see the sheet. So you can have unlimited sheets, and it's not hidden, it just doesn't show. So it gives you all the capabilities that you've got, and you can very easily hide and unhide. So you've built a perfect sheet for navigation in this example.